Welcome back, visual learners. Today we're going to be learning about a commonly used anti-gout medication called colchicine. So if you're ready, then grab your color pencils and let's color and learn. Colchicine is one of the oldest remedies still in use today. It dates back to 1500 BC when the Egyptians used it as an herbal remedy for joint pain. Let's color these letters in yellow and orange to remind us of its use for pain and inflammation due to gout. When you think of colchicine, use the visual anchor of a cool chicken since it sounds similar. The brand name for colchicine is Colchris. You can remember this since Colchris has part of the generic name in it, colchicine, and its ending "-chris," reminds you of the indication for gout caused by gouty crystals. As I stated before, colchicine is used in the prophylaxis and treatment of gout flares. It can also be used to treat familial Mediterranean fever. But what exactly is gout? Gout is a painful form of arthritis. When your body has extra uric acid, sharp crystals can form in your joints, usually your big toe. Flare-ups of symptoms like pain and swelling come and go in periods called gout attacks. It is recommended to initiate therapy as soon as possible, preferably within 12 to 24 hours of onset of gout flare for best results of symptom relief. Moving on to the mechanism of action. The exact mechanism of how colchicine works is not fully understood. It works primarily by decreasing inflammation and pain due to uric acid formation inside the joints through suppressing the activation, degranulation, and migration of neutrophils. How about the side effects? Overall, colchicine is a fairly safe drug with few side effects. We can remember the main side effects by using the mnemonic BAM, as in BAM. Gout flares can occur at any time. B stands for B12 deficiency. A stands for abdominal pain such as nausea and or vomiting and diarrhea. M is for myelosuppression with high doses and or muscle weakness and nerve weakness. Some important clinical pearls and counseling points to keep in mind. Definitely know the correct dosing for a gout attack, which is 1.2 milligrams or 2 of the 0.6 milligram tablets orally at the first sign of a gout attack. If gout symptoms persist, a repeat dose of 0.6 milligrams can be given in 1 hour. Do not take more than 1.8 milligrams or 3 tablets within 1 hour or 2.4 milligrams or 4 tablets in 24 hours due to serious side effects. You want to advise your patients to talk to their healthcare provider if serious GI side effects such as diarrhea, muscle soreness, or tingling in fingers or toes occur. Educate patients that weight loss and limiting alcohol consumption can reduce gout attacks. Alright guys, that was a lot of information, so let's take some time to review because repetition is the mother of all learning. When you think of colchicine, use the visual anchor of a cool chicken. And what isn't cool? Gout. It's not cool to have gout, a common form of inflammatory arthritis that is very painful. Gout most commonly presents in the big toe, causing severe pain, redness, and tenderness. Gout occurs when uric acid crystals accumulate in the joint, causing the inflammation and intense pain of a gout attack, as you can see here in this image. So how does colchicine work to treat gout? The mechanism of action is not fully understood, but it primarily works to decrease inflammation and pain due to uric acid crystal formation. It decreases inflammation by suppressing activation, degranulation, and migration of, what again? That's right, neutrophils. For side effects, we can remember that, bam, gout attacks can occur at any time. B is for B12 deficiency. A is for what? Yes, A is for abdominal pain, including nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. M is for myelosuppression and muscle weakness. You want to counsel your patients to avoid foods high in purines since uric acid is made from the breakdown of purines. Examples of foods to avoid include alcohol, sodas, fish, and liver. Finally, it's important to maintain adequate fluid intake to decrease future gout attacks and to take colchicine with a full glass of water. All right, guys, that's it for today. If you found this helpful, click that subscribe button for more. Let me know you have questions in the comments and I will be happy to answer them. If you're interested in getting more information from our Top 200 Drugs Made Easy coloring book, I'll leave a link to the product below in the description and I will see you in the next video.